In this very short tutorial, I'm going to share with you how to use Handbrake software to reduce the file size of your videos. Okay, so if you've not used Handbrake before, this is a very fantastic software and it's open source video transcoder. Handbrake is a tool for converting video from nearly any format to a selection of modern, widely supported codecs. So you can start by coming to handbrake.fr and coming here to download the software. You just click to download for Windows 10 and later version. If you have Windows 11, you can still work with it. You can use it for Mac, for Linux as well. All right. So once you download and install, it's very easy to download. It's very easy to install. Once you install yours, you can just come all the way to your start menu and just search for Handbrake. And you can see it over here. You just click on it to open. Okay, so you can see it over here. So the first thing you need to notice is that you can drag a file or folder and drop it over here containing the videos that you want to work on. But in my own case, I always go to file and then navigate to where I save the video. For example, in my own case, I save it here. And then let's say we click on this and then we can open to open it. You can see the video that we want to reduce the size. But before we go into it deeply, let's try to look at the original size. Okay, so let's try to look at the size. This is the video, and then let's right click and come to show more options and come to properties, and then we can see the size at this moment is 314 megabytes. So let's see the out after we edit it on Handbrake and see what kind of size it's going to come out with. So we're now back in Handbrake, and the first thing you need to do is you need to notice is you have a bunch of other features over here. If you want to open a source, you can easily click here to open a source file. Okay, you can navigate to open a source file, or you can add a given file to a queue if you have a given file already running or already encoding, and you can start encoder from here. You can queue different kind of folders or videos that you are reducing or you're working on. You can preview, you can do so, or you can check out the activity logs and presets that you've saved. So down here you have a bunch of options, but the most important part is to try to look at the dimensions, the summary. Okay, this is MP4. You're free to change it to MKV or WebM. You can keep all this at default, and these are the other properties that you can try to have a look. For example, this is the sizing as it is. So next you can check the dimension. You have the resolution limit. Right now it's set to HD, which is the 1080p. You can check out to see other resolutions as well if you want to go for lower versions. But at this point, I recommend you leave it at 1080p, which is the HD version. Okay, you can check other things if you want. You can play around with the sizing if you want from here. Right now it's set to automatic and the aspect ratio is set to 16:9. You can adjust all this, and the borders as well you can adjust. You can come to filters, and I usually leave this at default. I don't change anything, but you can come to videos, and then you can see the first thing you need to look into is the video encoder. So right now you can see it's at H.264, which is the MP4 format. You can check around, click this drop down, and you can see other formats that you can work around with. Okay, so but I usually go with the MP4 format. I leave it at default. You can play around with this frame rate. Right now it's set to 30. You can make it 24, or you can make it 29.97, which is usually the allowable one. So we can go for 29.97, or you can leave it at 30 if you want. Or in some cases, you may leave it as same as source. Okay, you can keep it as same as source, depending on you. But I always go for 29.97 where possible. Right, so you can keep it at constant frame rate, or you can keep it at peak frame rate, depending on your choice. Now the most important part of this editing is over the quality. Okay, so right now the constant quality is 22. If you like, you can increase it forward, and what this means is higher quality but then higher sizing. You can come a little bit from 22 to maybe you can increase it, so this is a bit of a lower quality but then lower in sizing. So this is a bit of lower quality but then lower in sizing. So right now the default that we found is 22. You can go as far as 25, okay, or let's say 26 to avoid distorting it too much, and then you can come over here and check out the distort the encoder options. Right now I leave it at the center. I don't touch that, and the encoder tone and everything, I don't touch all this. I only play with the quality at this point. So I just tilted it a bit from 22 to 26, and you can see so at the audio I don't touch anything, at the subtitles nothing, at the chapters nothing. The only thing I do is at the save as or the location, you can change if you so wish. So you can just browse, and let's say we go to the same location where the other one is, Now we can give change to them from introduction video to finished video. Okay, so you can check it and make it the finished video. You click on OK, and you can come all the way over here and start the encoding. Okay, so you just click on start encoding, and you can see it starts. You can stop, you can pause at any given point, or you, if you have another video that you want to encode, you can click to add it to a queue, or you can bring in another video if you want by opening the source or the about. You can see the progress, so you can just wait for it. As soon as it finishes, then we'll check and see how it affects the quality as well as the sizing. Okay, so right now it has finished, so let's try to look at the quality and try to compare the sizing as well. So this is the file. So this is the finished one. Let's try to, if you recall the first one, what was the size? Let's go to right click and we can go to properties, and we can see the first one was 314 megabytes, and now let's see the finished one, right? Small, and you can see it's now 22 megabytes. Wow, this is quite big in terms of the size reduction. So you can see the previous one is 314 and then back to 22 megabyte. This is quite big in terms of the reduction. So feel free to try it, feel free to experiment it, and let's try to play the quality and see the quality.
1,000 words,
there's no much difference.
If a picture is worth 1,000 words,
so when you want to reduce the sizing without affecting the quality, Handbrake can do the job for you. So ladies and gentlemen, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to always hit the subscribe and notification buttons to stay connected to this channel for more of our very, very useful videos. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.